Srettha Thavisin is set to be Thailand's next prime minister after securing enough votes in parliament. He is the Pheu Thai party's nominee for the post. His victory possibly putting an end to months of political deadlock that has frustrated the constituency and harmed confidence in the country's economic recovery. Resounding applause could be heard as votes for Mr. Srettha were announced. The 61-year-old real estate mogul secured 482 votes across the two houses of parliament, past the simple majority that's required to be successful. His win paves the way for Pheu Thai, which is helming an 11-party coalition to form Thailand's next government, despite coming in second at the May general election. The parliament vote came hours after fugitive former premier and Pheu Thai figurehead Thaksin Shinawat returned to Thailand after spending 15 years in self-imposed exile. For more, we're joined by our CNA correspondents in Bangkok, Saksit Sayasombat from the parliament and Mei Wong from the Pheu Thai headquarters. First, let's get to Saksit. Saksit, Thailand is finally seeing a new leader, but will this appointment of Srettha Thavisin to the prime ministerial seat end all of the political stalemate that we've seen in the country?
It really depends who you ask. A lot of people will say finally, and a lot of people will say that they're disappointed about what has happened, what has transpired, not only today in parliament, but over the past couple, 3 months since the general election. So just to recap, in May, the reformist Progressive Move Forward party won the most seats. They were trying to form a government. They were trying to put forward the leader, Peter Lim Cherannat, as prime minister, but he was blocked by the same chamber, by the same lawmakers here at parliament for their progressive reformist agenda. The Pheu Move Forward party, with no other way forward, had to relinquish their control, gave them to the Pheu Thai party, which came in second during the elections. Then the Pheu Thai party cobbled together a coalition with 10 other parties, some of them part of the former military government, some of them of the previous government, and especially governments linked to the previous military coups. Now, they have broken their own promises. They have gone into bed with parties they have called enemies not too long ago. But this is the arrangement that they have agreed on that has put Srettha Thavisin, the prime minister candidate, the former property tycoon, over the line. Whether or not this is going to end a political deadlock, whether or not this is going to dissolve political divisions, as the coalition has touted in the days leading up to this vote, that remains to be seen, because they say that have dissolved political lines, but it is now new lines have been drawn, and especially against the Move Forward party. And with a party, with a coalition that has so many parties and so many parties of the previous government, that is quite a daunting task for the government, for the new government, and for the new prime minister that he has to face. Whether or not he can face them, whether or not the tasks are not too big for them, well, this is the first day, and we will see how they're going to figure this out in the next few years.
On the point of how new lines are being drawn, at least politically, Saksit, we have a Pheu Thai candidate being catapulted to this top post on the same day that a former premier linked to the party has returned to Thailand, Thaksin Shinawat. What can we read into the timing of this?
Well, it cannot be a coincidence, because Thaksin Shinawat, who came back to Thailand after 15 years in self-exile, coming to Thailand knowing that he has been convicted to prison in absentia, knowing that he has been convicted for several cases ranging from malfeasance, corruption, and abuse of power, he must have gotten some assurances to be in prison for a minimum amount of time, or at the very least be comfortable in it. Otherwise, he wouldn't have tried and attempted to come back here to Thailand. And sure enough, he's now in a detention facility. He's now in Bangkok Remand Prison. And the question is, of course, like, how long is he going to stay there? Is he going to seek a royal pardon? How quickly will this royal pardon be issued to him? That is all going to be a big question going ahead. And of course, things are related. The prime minister's vote, the coalition that the Pheu Thai party has cobbled together with the military, with the parties linked to the military coups that have kicked out governments of Thaksin and his sister, Yingluck Shinawat, not too long ago in the past 20 years. So, all in all, the past 20 years in Thailand, they have all been dominated by Thaksin, and it goes to show that wherever he goes, he still leaves an impact, even until this day, because otherwise, we still wouldn't be talking about them.
The chess pieces continue to move on the board. Saksith Sayasombat, their reporting. This was live from Bangkok.
Well, loyal supporters of Pheu Thai have been waiting for the results of at the party headquarters. CNA's Mae Wong is right there. Now, Mae, you've been monitoring the press conference by the Prime Minister-elect. What did he say?
It wasn't really a press conference, to be honest with you. Srettha Thavisin, after he heard the results, he came down to the press room, but he didn't give any interviews whatsoever. Well, in fact, I just wanted to show you there are some, actually, individuals walking in right now. And let's take a look at who they are. I'm trying to see it would be one of the, one of the coalition party members, actually. That would be Seri Pitsu. He's coming here into Pheu Thai. He's not a Pheu Thai member, and he's not part of the Pheu Thai party, but he is actually a part of the coalition of the 11 coalition parties that Pheu Thai has actually come together, coordinated in order to get the votes today. Coming back to the point earlier for Srettha Thavisin, he didn't answer any questions. All he did was to give approximately a 2-minute kind of address to the media to say that he's honoured to become the next Prime Minister, that he will create prosperity and also come up with economic policies in order to help uplift the lives of the citizen. That is a perennial line that Pheu Thai as well as Srettha Thavisin have been saying time and again, because they say the time is now to set up a government more than 3 months after the general elections so that the country can finally move on. Initially, I also tried to ask him, what kind of a prime minister do you want to be for the people? His only answer to me was he wants to be the people's prime minister, and he refused to actually detail on how he intends to do just that.
Now, it's still mixed emotions for the party supporters, isn't it? Because it is a day when the former Prime Minister Thaksin Shinawat was jailed. How would you describe the mood there?
Absolutely. I mean, it is a mixed day of emotions as well as reactions. But at the end of the day, it eventually ended up in terms of pure elation. First of all, with Prime Minister or ex-Prime Minister Thaksin Shinawat coming back into the country, that already brought about tremendous joy to some of the Pheu Thai supporters, simply because of the fact that ultimately, I'm just going to move away because we're getting pushed over. All these supporters here, ultimately, they are actually throwing their support behind not just Srettha Thavisin, but also to welcome the ex-Prime Minister Thaksin Shinawat back. They actually admitted and agreed the fact that he needs to go into prison for the past convictions that have already been laid out for him. So as long as he's back in the country, they're very happy about that, because for numerous times they've actually not been able to see that happen. So this already was good enough for them. And yet today, double happiness in a way to see Pheu Thai's Srettha Thavisin become or designated to become the next Prime Minister of this country. And finally, more than 3 months after an election, they will finally have a Prime Minister for this country. And so they were absolutely joyous. They went onto the streets, actually started dancing, and also many of them, they were tearing up, crying and thumping their chest, and also giving the thumbs up sign earlier when the results came out. So all of these, at the end of the day, they are still hoping to see some change in the country because they believe in Pheu Thai party. But before I wrap up really quickly, there is another side which you're not seeing here in the Pheu Thai party, which are the people who did not vote for Pheu Thai, who felt that the election results were snatched away from them, and that was because the winning party of Move Forward party did not become the Prime Minister, did not become the government of the day, and those are the people who claim that Srettha Thavisin is not the people's Prime Minister, not the people's choice. So it'll be a very tough road ahead in order to unite Thailand once again.
Mae, thank you. Mae Wong taking the temperature at Pheu Thai party headquarters in Bangkok. We will discuss the developments in Thailand with an expert from Bauer Group Asia a little later in the show.